Obviously, some disturbing scenes coming from the north of the country. Violent protests in response to President Jonathan being declared the winner. Why this reaction?
Well, I must say it wasn't completely unexpected. Several concerns had been raised about the tenor of some of the pronouncements that General Buhari had made, and his deputy as well, his running mate, the pastor Tunde Bakare. Their campaigns had generally raised fears. There was a perception by their followers, it seemed, that they had to win. That was the impression that was being created. And it was not completely unexpected that those supporters of General Buhari, who tend to be a very volatile mix of the underclass and lower classes in the north, would react violently, as we have seen.
But I mean, obviously, there have been allegations of vote rigging and a few irregularities. Obviously, some investigations have to be underway. But is there some validity to that?
Well, from what most of us could see, the voting appeared transparent. I voted in my district like most Nigerians. We waited, we saw the results collated, we counted the results together, and we saw the process, and it looked transparent. Now, I don't rule out the possibility that things untoward may have happened, perhaps in rural areas where there's no media, perhaps in more remote areas of the country. But the reaction, even if you think that has happened, is obviously not to go on a spree of violence and looting and burning and killing. So for some of us, this is an unfortunate turn, and the elections, which we felt had gone very well, as most observers and international and local observers felt, now has been tainted with this unfortunate turn of events.
But I mean, obviously, there is a historical precedence, if not necessarily in elections, but this speaks to the divide between North and South, which has been pervasive throughout the entire electoral period, where there seems to be a sense that there's a visceral problem between Northern Nigerians, Southern Nigerians, and perceptions of religious differentiation and all those kinds of issues. This election, with the PDP candidate being a southerner in the form of the incumbent, the northern candidate in the form of Mr. Buhari being a northerner, seems to have preyed on some of those tensions.
Clearly, the elections and the whole process leading up to it, the arguments over zoning, the death of former President Yar'Adua, the perception from the north that it was still their turn to present a president. I think, however, that we have had a little bit of irresponsible campaigning, I would say, which has served to widen those demarcations between the Nigerian people. I think that hopefully those bridges, I mean, those gulfs that has been created, they are not unbridgeable. I think that at the end of the day, I believe that Nigerians want to live together. I think that a large part of people, illiterate, uneducated, may have been misled. And I hope that the security and the leadership of the country can restore peace in all those parts.
I mean, you refer to the fact that people still feel that for the North, it was still their turn. Just explain what that means, because obviously within the ruling PDP, there is a gentleman's agreement as to the rotation of power between North and South. And obviously with the late President Yar'Adua, he'd come in as a ruling party candidate from the North, but unfortunately due to illness, could not complete his term. How can that issue be resolved at this time? If people still feel that it's their turn, they may make it very difficult for President Jonathan to govern going forward.
But let's bear in mind that President Jonathan scored 25% of the votes, and indeed up to 40% in several of the northern states. So it's a bit misleading to believe that the whole of the northern part, and indeed one in three northern states, and one generally in the north central, in virtually all the states except Niger in the north central, and in the northeast and northwest, except in three or four states, he scored more than the constitutionally required 25% in all those states. So he has significant support in the North. However, yes, because of the tenor, I think, and the makeup of the support of General Buhari in particular, those reservations have been made more volatile. And because of the nature of the support base the general has, which is generally a little bit volatile, youths, uneducated, and all of that, this demarcation has been made worse. Yeah, but then President Jonathan has the challenge of reuniting the country, of restoring peace, and of bringing together, reconciling all those who feel aggrieved.
Let's talk about that reconciliation as a final question. What sort of things could he do? Could he try to involve the CPC in his new administration? Could he directly extend an olive branch to General Buhari and try to involve him within his current administration?
President Jonathan has generally adopted that posture. To be fair to him, he has continued to speak like a statesman, to seek to bridge the gaps, to seek to involve to his opponents, and he has never really alienated them. It's unfortunate that these developments have taken this turn. However, yes, you're right. We need a continuous reaching out to particularly the elements in the CPC, and even outside the CPC, those the Northern Political Leaders Forum, some aggrieved politicians and groups who believe that, either power or nothing. I think President Jonathan has the character and the humility and the consensus-building approach to achieve reconciliation.